Here we go. We have our very first match of today's America's Cup. We've got Heaves. We've got Dreams. Joseph Heaves with the first pick, but pre-bans are coming out now.
Interesting pre-bands of Chiwoo and Josephine. So we'll see. Clearly, Heaves is planning on going with the aggression route, but Dreams Joseph has taken of eliminating a lot of options. We know that Heaves does like to use Savannah a lot, but Heaves does also have a very good turn two comp. We see a very standard Hathor first pick. Dreams Joseph does rely on Beast Riders, so he's going to pick some first few picks to be able to enable the Beast Riders later on in the draft.
Yep, there's the Fran coming out for Dreams Joseph. He's going to be splitting that Ganni Hathor, taking Ganni himself. Heaves quickly responding with the Ciara in Okeanos.
Definitely needs to split the Ganni Hathor here, and I wouldn't be surprised to see Dreams Joseph take a more aggressive route here. You know he likes to abuse those Beast Riders. That Masha is very, very well ruined on lots of damage here. So he takes that speed lead of Vanessa and the Masha to be able to compete with speed. Then, of course, Fran is protection against both AoE control units of Heaves.
Now that's double fire coming out of Dreams Joseph. Curious what Heaves going to be drafting here after seeing a Vanessa Masha coming into the picture.
Yeah, I wouldn't be surprised to see some sort of water unit. So very much so a Vigor. And actually, Molly would not be. I know we've bashed on Molly a lot before, but Molly's emerged a lot. Definitely a lot of water because that's a lot of fire that Dreams Joseph is representing from his side. So Vigor and Water Monkey King, both very good options. Vigor is going to be able to allow Dreams Heaves to be able to take many, many turns to take advantage of this game. Water Monkey, lots of damage overall.
I like that we just saw that Wind Monkey King flash. He might go with this Diana here, but I know he picked that Wind Monkey King before.
Yeah, so when he flashes the Diana or the Wind Monkey King, you know he's going to ban out one of the fire units. It's probably where his head's, or one of the water units, but takes out the Hathor and decides that he needs his Fran to resist his Okeanos. Otherwise, he's in a lot of trouble because if he doesn't have immunity, that could be all she wrote.
That's right. Hathor, Diana getting banned out. Heaves, Dreams, Joseph going to be round one between the two of them. Very exciting to see this get kicked off. And here we go. Heaves with the first turn. Okeanos looking for a reset.
Yeah, and actually Dreams Joseph's team super well-tuned, so it's actually very difficult to know what the turn orders are, and so Heaves actually has a decision point to make here.
Went to go for the reset on the Ganni, but the Ganni did resist, still having that skill 3 up. Seal of Magic coming out on to the Vigor, resetting that Vigor.
We're going to see a unit go down really soon here, because Dreams Joseph has attack buff from the Fran, and then has a Masha following up, so that's going to be a lot of damage that Heaves is going to take. Look to see which unit drops first, and Heaves is going to have to come back 3-4.
Pulling out an Alter Ego to deal some damage to this Masha. Masha's still taking it very well. Fran with the attack buff, heal coming out. We're going to see some damage coming from Masha. Ooh, Masha getting that defense break, dealing massive damage to Okeanos. Vanessa's going to be finishing off that Okeanos. Damage being dealt to Ciara.
Yeah, and what's also valuable here is that Vanessa still has that skill 2 defense break, so once that gets online, that Ciara's in a lot of trouble. Heaves does have heal and anti-crit from Vigor, but again, 3 units versus 4 does not put him in a good spot.
That's right. Possible glancing going out onto the Ciara. Already has that slow as well. Reventilates back onto the Fran. Bomb coming out on Masha. He needs to stun up this unit now before it starts dealing more damage. That vent did come out onto Fran. Does get that stun, putting Masha in just that human form.
At the same time, Fran does have skill 2, is going to be able to cleanse that Masha, so Heaves is still going to be eating damage on the Ciara that's already at half health.
That's right. There's no reset on that Vanessa. If he gets rid of this Masha, it's going to be reviving back because of Vanessa, and it'll be on a Beast this time.
Yeah, and Dreams Joseph does need to decide, does he want to protect his team, knowing that his Masha can come back, or does he want to go for aggression? Choose to go for aggression.
Goes for the aggression, gets the additional turn anyways, immunity and attack buffs coming back.
Immunity and attack buff coming back, and that's a big defense break on that Ciara, so Ciara's not able to drop it.
Another additional turn coming out, you can see taking advantage of that defense break sitting on top of Ciara. Ciara's able to plant a bomb down. Trying to shake that defense break, does so, an additional turn does come out from Ciara.
But it's going to eat damage to the face from this Masha. This Masha is going to be saying, see you later.
That's
and now
right.
Heaves is down.
And another additional turn. Oh, man! Masha doing away with that Water Monkey, just a lonely Vigor. And this is going to be it for Heaves. He's got to really think about this one. Maybe not letting Dreams Joseph get a hold of that Ganni Vanessa Masha team.
Very well calculated draft from Dreams Joseph puts Heaves on the back foot here.
There you have it, round one going to Dreams Joseph.
What a game there. I actually think this was a very well calculated draft from Dreams Joseph here, knowing that the speeds of the game too early, or it was the last two picks on the two water units. I think one of them could have been some piece of immunity or some way to play back. I think going in all in like that with two water units, a little bit too risky here. double bans on the Beast Rider. So Dreams Joseph very well calculated, actually thinking through the decision tree, knowing that if Heaves has a Chiwu, that Savannah is a very difficult unit to deal with. So I like that ban from Dreams Joseph. Heaves just reactionary ban on the Masha. I'm not sure how I feel about that, but at the same time, Dreams Joseph did use that unit very well.
That's right. Heaves going to be drafting the Fran and Ganny. Heaves drafting the Fran and Ganny. Dreams Joseph with that first pick, taking in that Hathor, thinking about a Vanessa right now. And I do believe he still has one other Beast Rider. He has that Barbara in stock.
And I don't think a Barbara is great into this specific lineup here, but he's thinking probably two choices, either going for the kill instantly with some sort of a Daphnis play, something super aggressive, or with a more control play with Anoki, or the slower team route with the Vigor here. I think Vigor is a little bit more neutral, but this type of draft does open him up to some sort of a Sierra X play. Maybe a Sierra Wind Art Master would be very cool to see, but definitely a Sierra is coming in play here. It could be an Oki. Oki's not the best into a Vigor, but Ganny Oki lockdown is very impressive, so those are the two units we see.
Yep, double reset's going to be very, very important. Dreams Joseph loves this Josephine, and having that Ganny on the field is going to be very strong with against this Josephine.
Yeah, and he's going to lay a Josephine here, but he needs to play one more unit that provides some sort of a support, some sort of heal. Otherwise, he's going to open himself up to a Diana with a ban onto the Hathor here. So Dreams Joseph does need to lay in some sort of other support unit. Honestly, a little light on damage here. So an immune piece of immunity would be great. Goes with the Wind Art Master.
That's
Chong Pao.
Very interesting. I think Dreams Joseph already calling the ban on the Ganny already.
So when he lays a Chong Pao like this, this is probably actually, I would actually say it's a ban on the Okeanos here, because he needs to be able to establish some sort of control. Heaves needs to establish some sort of control, and Dreams Joseph wants to take that away by taking out either the Oki or could be the Ganny. One of the two units has to be split here. But I really like that pick from Dreams Joseph here. I mean, it's a lot of damage, lots of control if there's no immunity.
I do like the Wind Druid coming out for Heaves. I think it's a very smart pick, very safe pick coming from him.
Yeah, it's a very safe pick, but one thing I am worried about is the Wind Druid actually does not take care of the Vigor very well. Vigor does allow turn cycling, lots of movement. We do see a split, as you call it, ban on the Ganny. Nice call, Stoic. So the Ganny goes away. We're going to see Dreams Joseph here with a little bit of a lack of damage. That Oki needs to land or Heaves is in trouble.
Speed lead for both team. Dreams Joseph, the 33, though. If Dreams Joseph gets the 2-0, he's going to be moving forward. Let's find out. And here we go. First turn is going to be going to, I'm sorry, yeah, Heaves with the Okeanos. Oh, I'm sorry, not Okeanos, that was the Hathor.
Hathor goes in with the skill 3. Actually, that's a very fast Hathor, going faster than the Okeanos, so it might even be a swift Hathor here. And actually, at this point, Dreams Joseph is just going to turn cycle and turn cycle over and over again.
Gets that provoke onto the Fran. Fran's not going to be buffing up any immunity right now.
That's a very giant provoke.
Ooh, going in for a shred, gets the additional turn as well, landing that 3-turn defense break. Ooh, and the additional turn coming from the Fran. Fran chooses to put up that immunity.
Giant, giant proc there, laying up immunity. It's pretty huge here because now it's very difficult for Dreams Joseph to be able to lay any sort type of control onto Heave's team.
Another additional turn coming from Dreams Joseph. He's able to pummel in some damage on top of that Fran. That's defense broken right now. I think we might be seeing a Soul Protect coming out for Fran. Choosing not to, goes for a wild blow onto the Vigor.
Yeah, chooses not to because Hathor does have that sleep with skill 2 and would strip that off, and that would be the end of Fran. So wisely being very patient here, and Dreams Joseph should take out that Fran, look to see Heaves, bring up that Fran, and try to find a window to keep it up through the game.
All right, well, here we go. See that additional turn once again coming out of Vanessa, getting stunned up this time. Josephine looking for the stun on Ciara and lands it. Hathor with the attack break to make sure those bombs are not going to be dealing much damage.
Yeah, and Dreams Joseph is actually in a really good spot here. If he goes for a defense break on the Sierra and gets it, that's a lot of damage.
There's that defense break sitting on top of Sierra. No additional turn this time, though. We see the revive coming back for Fran. Can Fran possibly get the wheels turning for Heaves?
It's going to be a little bit difficult that Fran is going after the entire team of Dreams Joseph, so he's going to have to eat 3 shots to the face here in order to survive.
Yep, attack break sitting on top of Fran right now. We all know that skill 2 is going to be based off of her attack. She's not going to be dealing much damage after that. Does resist the defense break coming from Vanessa.
It's the world's biggest resist on the defense break because that Fran is up, so he's going to be able to pump in heals.
Woo, and Fran does hold on. Fran's going to be healing itself, possibly healing up the CR as well. That defense break looking very devastating. Chooses to heal himself, hoping for that additional turn.
Yeah, laying on that Rain of Spawns is going to give Josephine a turn, which is going to be some damage as he's going to be able to lay into CR here. So look to see the skill 2 go on that CR strip and do some damage here. But right now, it could go to anyone's way here.
Yep, really could. Stun did land on top of Hathor. Not anybody else, though. We've got Windroot primed and ready for a massive wild blow. Not sure it's going to be the damage he's looking for. Does Shadow Shield on top of the Vega.
Yeah, but at the same time, that Wild Blow doesn't do a lot of damage. Vigors are built generally on HP build, so very, very tanky units. Lots of speed buffs, lots of defense breaks. Very, very difficult to unit to deal with now.
Stun does go out on the Okeano. Ciara barely holding on here. I think Josephine's going to be doing it right there. Does so, drops that Ciara, and we're looking for an attack break onto Vanessa and does land.
Yeah, and he's lost his primary damage dealer right now. Does not have any more damage in the back pocket. Terranese doesn't do anything. So James Joseph is going to sweep this 2-0 and start off strong here.
Another additional turn coming out of Dreams Joseph. Misses the defense break on top of the Fran. We've seen another turn coming out of the Vigor. Looking to finish off this Fran. Does get the heal block, though.
Yeah, but it doesn't really matter. Again, that skill 3 up from Hathor just seals the deal. Heaves is going to go home here, and Dreams Joseph is going to move on and probably win some money today.
That's right. Dreams Joseph's going to be taking his time here, making sure he makes all the right moves. There really isn't much Heaves can do here, but I guess he's going to be holding on for something. There it is. Finishes off the Okeanos, finishing off that Fran as well with the Vanessa. Attack break sitting on top of this Wind Druid. And there you have it. Round 2. That's it. Dreams Joseph 2-0's Heaves.
Wow, what a match. Dreams Joseph made that look easy. Easy.
And we talked about
how good Heaves was taking down Tom.